All right. Well, we're in Iowa. Iowa. And it's been raining on me for 150 miles. Anyway, we are in Burlington, Iowa, which is right inside Illinois, like, I don't know, 5 miles or so. It is Friday at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, which really sucks for me. Oh man, this is not going to be a good week for Miles. It is going to be a terrible week for Miles, as a matter of fact. Monday we dropped in Nashville, Tennessee. We picked up just outside of Nashville, about 60 miles, and picked up lumber and went to North Carolina. It was a total of like 300 miles. Delivered that on Tuesday. and then we picked up in... Where did we pick up? We picked up in North Carolina lumber, actually pressed particle board stuff for a Home Depot distribution center in New Jersey. And that was delivering on Thursday night, like 6:30 at night. Anyway, I ended up getting there around 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And surprisingly, those guys were really cool because there was nothing going on, and unloaded me. And really quick, we got this load. And this is where things go south as far as miles go, because it's supposed to have delivered tomorrow morning, Saturday. Well, that's not going to do me any good. But I found out this place is a 24/7 operation. I could deliver anytime. So my appointment picking up at the Camden, New Jersey port was 8 o'clock on Thursday morning. Yeah, yesterday morning. Anyway, I got there and spent the night there, and got up in the morning, and got checked in, and at 8 o'clock, they started doing their thing, positioned me, loaded me with these two coils, and I got out of there by 10:30. I was out of there by 10:30. And I rolled until about 9 o'clock last night. Got to the border of Indiana on 70 to that Petro, and shut down at 9 o'clock last night. By the time I got my post trip and everything, it was about 9:10, 9:15. So I couldn't start rolling until 7 o'clock this morning, a little after seven, obviously. So I got up, did my pre-trip, and rolled out of there on the dot. Took off. Now, the best I could do was get here at 1 o'clock. So the only thing I did was my load checks, and I had to stop and get fuel. Didn't even do a 30. I didn't need a 30. That was my goal, was not to have to do a 30. Get here as soon as I can. So here I am. I'm trying to. So the guy told me, he goes, get all your securement off, get all the bungees off, leave the tarp on because we don't want it to get too wet. Which, anyway, I drive in there, they unload me, and I drive out the other end. But it's not really raining right now, so I'll probably take the tarp off and roll it up out here. Maybe I'll just roll it in there. I don't know. I'm not very happy. But it's just, you know, it's just the way things go sometimes. Just the way things go. Listen, I work for a company, okay? And me getting miles does not necessarily mean that that's the best thing for the company. Because in a perfect world, they should have gotten me a load on Thursday that delivered this morning. You know what I mean? Like a short run. I mean, that's a perfect world. And then I would have been unloaded and ready for get my weekend load and run. By the Friday at 1 o'clock, by the time I get undone and everything, it'll be 2 o'clock. There's not going to be any loads. So I'll probably be sitting for the weekend. That's just the way it goes in trucking. And right now, you know, the loads are terrible. The loads are terrible. I'm not the only one that's hurting, you know, and the 3,000 mile loads, 3,000 mile weeks are rare now. Very rare. Very rare. Very, very rare. So, the pandemic, I'm telling you what, the pandemic was a blast. You ran. People quit. The amount of drivers that quit during that time was unbelievable. They quit. And Melton put a freeze on for a while. So we didn't have any drivers. We really didn't. We had about, I don't know, between 1,000 and 1,200 at any given time during the pandemic. And I'm telling you, businesses pumped out freight, and we ran. If you got less than 3,000 miles in a week, you were not happy. You know what I mean? I mean, it was nothing to do back-to-back 3,000, 3,500. You know, three times I can remember, I did 4,200 miles in a week during that period. And you know, you just ran. It was great, man. It was the best time to really be a truck driver. Now, there's no freight. There's no miles. All my runs are real short now. I don't even know what a long run looks like anymore. I don't even know what the West Coast looks like anymore. Because I haven't been to the West Coast in over a year. Now, granted, I had my health issues, I was off my truck and things like that. But I've been on my truck and I've been running, and I'm telling you, you're lucky if you get. Last week I got 2,500 miles, and I was freaking grateful for 2,500 miles, which is ridiculous. This week, two things. Either one, I'm not getting a load and I'm only going to have 1,900 miles. Or two, they might get me a load and I'll probably have maybe, they'll probably give me it'll probably be some short run or something like that, 500. So, you know, I'll be 2,400 miles or whatever probably. But, and Melton is still hiring drivers, so, you know. That is not good for drivers, but it is what it is, you know? It is what it is. I can't, I don't know where to throw that shit. So, you have to just deal with it, you know? Okay, why isn't that one come off? Okay, that one's not coming off. I may have to take my... So, and like I said, I don't want to complain, it's not against Melton or anything like that, so, You know, just understand that it is what it is, man. Can't do anything else about it. So if you're gonna be a truck driver, you know, get ready. You're gonna be sitting around. That is part of the game. Part of the game. Sitting around. Damn. So, anyway, that's that. That is that. Why do we keep getting that one to come off? I don't know what's... Did I not undo it? Is going to be any good. Quite honest with you. So I didn't think that he's obviously got coils in there. I wonder how many coils he's got in that dry van. So what I'm going to do is once I get all these rolled up, I'm going to pull up to that thing, see how long it takes them, and I might take my tarp off. We'll see. We'll see. Too cold. It's colder than I thought it was. Probably, I don't know. Probably in the 50s. It's not raining right now. Yeah, what I'm gonna do is once I get these all rolled up, I should talk about. So I loaded with two other company drivers from other companies, okay? And one of those company drivers drove for a company, and I'm not going to tell you the name, but just suffice it to say their tarps are black and white. All right? Anyway, this kid... I say kid, he was a good driver. You know, we sat there and we talked. Actually, he's coming here to unload as well. But this is what I want to bring up. Like I was saying that he applied for the other company, that there was another company there, and they would not hire him because he had felonies. Now, in this day and age, a lot of companies will hire you with felonies. It just depends on what felonies. One of his felonies was an aggravated assault, okay? Which means that he assaulted somebody. I don't know how he assaulted him. He could have assaulted him with a gun, a bat, a hand, whatever. But he obviously caused some kind of bodily injury to that person, right? And so that company wouldn't hire him for that. His other felony was possession, drug possession, right? They would have hired him for that if that was his only felony. But because he had the aggravator, they wouldn't hire him, okay? So really what it comes down to is, you know, companies don't want people that have a violent violent history, because that, you know, that leads to possible, you know, violence at the workplace. So they can't take a chance with you with that on your, with that kind of history, right? And I really believe he was a good driver. Talking to him, I was watching him do his load and everything. He was doing everything right. And he's been doing trucking since 2020. So he's done everything right. I mean, I watched him. He was really good. And then he asked me if, you know, Melton will take him with that kind of felony. And I told him, I said, I don't know, to be honest with you. I don't have any felonies, so I've never had to deal with anything like that. So he said, you know, the best you can do is call a recruiter or whatever and find out. You know, he was in shock that I was getting $100 to tarp this load. He's only getting $25 to tarp the same load. You know? So I guess what I'm saying to you is, as a young person, you know, you need to think about things. You need to think about things. You know, if somebody does you wrong, you're going to show him and you're going to fight them or whatever. Well, understand, there may be some consequences, you know, down the road. And that guy was, that, I asked him, I said, well, how old are you? And he said, 35. And I said, man, your 20s probably weren't good to you. He goes, you have no idea. Well, I probably do have an idea. And I think that guy, I mean, I could see it in his face. He, you know, he, you could see that he was really regretting the things that he had done in his younger days, because they're affecting him right now. Because I think, because he wants to be a truck driver, and unfortunately, he's got to work for a company that will take him, but they're not, you know, they're not going to pay him. You know, they're not going to treat him as good. You know, where Melton can be a little bit pickier about who they hire, right? Sometimes I wish they'd be even more pickier. But, you know, and again, I don't know what Melton's felony policy is. I really don't. But I'm just telling you, as a young person, whether you want to be a truck driver or what, you need to pay attention to what you're doing, because it may affect you for the rest of your life. It may affect you. I'm going to tell you a story about me. When I was in the ninth grade, I'd already taken my test. It was the last 4 days of school. So I couldn't wait to get out of school. I know I was going to be going to the senior high next year. Summer was upon me. I was living in Florida at the time. And I was ready, you know, ready to be surfing and water skiing. We had a boat, you know, so we water skied all summer long. Shoot. So I was ready for the summer. Anyway, long story short, I got in a fight at school. And me and that kid, basically they suspended both of us for the last 4 days of school. It didn't affect my grades or anything like that. I had good grades, so it didn't affect me any that like that. But my dad was not happy. He was not happy. And he said something to me, and it's always stuck with me ever since. He said, you know, things like that, violence against other people can cause you problems down the road. He said, let's say you want to go to college. The college looks up and finds that you were suspended for fighting. So they may not want to bring you to their campus. So now you can't go to college. So now you got to go get a job. And they find out that you got in a fight, they may not hire you. And I've always thought about that. I really have. Always thought about that. So, paid attention, man. I paid attention. Now that situation did not affect me. I got, you know, it was just a harmless fight. I think I had a fat lip and he had a bloody nose. But, you know, we went on our way. Now where it did affect me, my dad. If my dad ever starts a sentence with beans howl, know you're going to be in trouble. So anyway, my dad came home and he said to me, he said, beans how you're going to be here for a while. Well, I'm thinking to myself, a while? Shoot, I'm going to the beach, man. What are you talking about? At that moment, I knew I wasn't going to the beach for a while. My dad bought a bunch of paint and stuff. 3 weeks, I painted the house inside and out. Mom took it better than my dad. My mom just kind of laughed about it. But anyway, that's just something I'm just, you know, you just take that with a grain of salt. Deal with it how you want. But that guy for them really should be with another company, and he should be making more money. When I told him how much money I was making, he's been in trucking. You know, I've been in trucking a little longer than him, obviously, but he should be making more money. He should be making more for a tarp job. But something that he did in his past is causing him not to move, excel. So that's all I'm going to say about that.